हेलो एवरीवन, सो इन टुडेस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्क्राइब द माइसीटोमा एंड क्रोमोब्लास्टोमाइकोसिस। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद माइसीटोमा। सो माइसीटोमा, इट इज़ अ क्रोनिक प्रोग्रेसिव डिसीज सो विच अफेक्ट्स द स्किन। व्हाट वर द कॉसेस ऑफ द माइसीटोमा? सो फॉर द पॉइंट ऑफ इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द FMG एग्जाम्स, वी जस्ट हैव टू रिमेंबर फ्यू पॉइंट्स। लाइक इन माइसीटोमा कैन बी कॉज्ड बाई बैक्टीरिया और फंजाई। सो इफ द Mycetoma is caused by fungi, then it is known as eumycetoma. Then it is known as eumycetoma. While if it is caused by bacteria, then it is known as actinomycetoma. Mycetoma. So here, if the grains contain the fungal hyphae, so if grains contain fungal hyphae which were more than 2 micron, then it is eumycetoma. Or in the short, we can say if it is eumycetoma which is caused by fungal hyphae, means it is a true mycetoma, because mycetoma is a fungal infection, fungal disease. So if it is caused by fungi, then it is eumycetoma, and eu means true mycetoma. While the actinomycetoma, which is caused by bacteria, so it is caused by filamentous bacteria. If we see filamentous bacteria which is less than 2 micron, then it is actinomycetoma. Actinomycetoma is a gram positive. Please remember that it is a gram positive bacteria involvement, then it is actinomycetoma. Now, what were the causes of eumycetoma and actinomycetoma? So for the actinomycetoma, the most common cause will be actinomedurae, or also actinomyces, or the nocardia. So all these cause the actinomycetoma. Then what were the causes of the eumycetoma? So the most common cause for eumycetoma will be medurella. Please remember, it is medurella mycetomatis. While in the actinomycetoma, the name itself comes, that is actino, means actinomedurae is caused by actinomycetoma, and medurella mycetomatis is caused by eumycetoma. And what kind of image we used to see? So here, this is the clinical finding which we see in mycetoma. These were the multiple discharging sinuses which we see here. So in this, what happens? In this, there is multiple discharging sinuses. So when these sinuses get healed, after some times, when they healed, they become fibrosis, means fibrosis will be there. So when the fibrosis will be there, so on the morphology, we see that sun ray appearance will be seen. So as here we see, these were look like sun ray appearances. So sun ray appearances is seen in actinomyces. So in actinomyces, sun ray appearances will be there, and these sun rays will, why it is there? Because as it is a splendor hopley phenomena, which is also seen, splendor hopley phenomena is also seen in orthotics. We use to see splendor hopley phenomena. So that is about the mycetoma. For mycetoma, just have to remember, these are eumycetoma, actinomycetoma. If in the question it mentions that the patient did not get recover after taking antibiotics, then it means that it is caused by fungal. So then the answer must be eumycetoma. If the person get better after taking antibiotics, then it is actinomycetoma, because antibiotic works on against the bacteria. So this is the main difference about eumycetoma and actinomycetoma. And also please remember this, that eumycetoma is caused by medurella mycetomatosis. So, and this typical image is seen in the actinomyces. Now the next one, that is the chromoblastomycosis. Chromo means color, like there were different colors we used to see here. The other name for chromoblastomycosis is verrucous वेरुसस डर्मेटाइटिस, वेरुसस डर्मेटाइटिस, वेरुकस डर्मेटाइटिस इज द अदर नेम फॉर क्रोमोब्लास्टोमाइकोसिस. एंड वट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज? सो द मोस्ट कॉमन क्रोमोब्लास्टोमाइकोसिस विल बी क्रोमोमाइकोसिस, क्रोमोमाइकोसिस, इट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज. नाउ वट वर द डिफरेंट क्लिनिकल फीचर्स वी यूज टू सी इन द क्रोमोब्लास्टोमाइकोसिस? सो इन दिस वी यूजली सी वार्टी कोलीफ्लावर लाइक लीजन्स. वार्टी वी यूज टू सी डिफरेंट वार्ट्स एंड ऑल्सो विच रिजेंबल फ्लोरेट्स ऑफ अ कोलीफ्लावर, ऑफ अ कोलीफ्लोर. And what were the risk factor? So the risk factor for this is when if the person visit in to a tropical area, or if person walks barefoot, like without wearing slippers, person is walking in a agriculture workers, so barefoot agriculture workers. Or wood cutters. So in these people there is highest risk of causing chromoblastomycosis, because chromoblastomycosis is a traumatic implantation. It is a traumatic implantation. So traumatic implantation. And in the chromoblastomycosis, as we see here in this image, that these lesions will look like a cauliflower, like cauliflower like warty lesions. Warty lesions. And here this is a very typical image. If you see this image in your exam, please remember that the name of this is like, it looks like a copper penny, or we can say a medullar body, or the other name is muriform bodies, or also we can say sclerotic bodies. So it looks like a copper penny, please remember, because its color is like copper color. So that's why we can say them that these are copper penny bodies, copper penny bodies, and the other name for it is medullar body or muriform bodies, or also we can say sclerotic bodies. So these were all about the chromoblastomycosis, and in this image also you can easily see that these are a copper penny bodies. Please remember, this is very very important image, as already asked in previous year questions. So please remember it. Now let's move to the other part, that is the fungus which cannot be cultured, like the, all those what were the can you please tell me which fungus we cannot be cultured? So there are two fungi which we cannot be cultured. The first one is the Pneumocystis jirovecii, which we cannot cultured, Pneumocystis jirovecii, or we can say Pneumocystis carinii, Pneumocystis carinii. And the other fungus which we cannot be cultured is Rhinosporidium seaberi. Please remember, Rhinosporidium seaberi. So these were two fungi which we cannot, which are cannot be cultured. Please remember, Pneumocystis jirovecii and Rhinosporidium seaberi. So as we discuss Pneumocystis jirovecii already in the medicine books. So in what we used to see in Pneumocystis jirovecii, so in Pneumocystis jirovecii we used to write like PCP, that is pneumonia carinii, Pneumocystis carinii pneumonia. So because it caused PCP, because it caused the pneumonia like situation, and it usually causes in HIV positive patients. So it causes in HIV positive patients. And what kind of image we used to see here? So in this image, first of all, identify the stain. Here the balls were looking like black. So in this we used GMS stain, Gomery methamine silver stain. So this stain is used for Pneumocystis jirovecii. And which type of sample we used to say? We used to take bronchoalveolar lavage for culturing the, not for culturing, for staining the Pneumocystis jirovecii. And what we used to see like some bowl get crushed and सम पिंग पोंग बॉल इज देयर, और वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज टू से क्रस्ट बॉल अपियरेंस, और वी कैन से पिंग पोंग बॉल अपियरेंस विल बी देयर, एंड ऑल्सो वी कैन से हैट एंड कप अपियरेंस, हैट एंड कप अपियरेंस, और वी कैन से सॉसर अपियरेंस. सो दीज वर द अपियरेंस ऑफ दीज बोल लाइक स्ट्रक्चर दैट इज निमोसिस्टर जीरोएसी, एंड इट अफेक्ट्स द आवर लंग्स, दैट्स वाई इट इज पल्मोनरी अफेक्टेड. सो निमोनिया, इट कैन कॉज निमोनिया. नाउ द अदर वन दैट इज द राइनोस्पोरिडियोसिस, विच इज ऑल्सो नॉट गेट कल्चर्ड. सो राइनोस्पोरिडियोसिस सी बेरी द विच इज कैन नॉट बी कल्टिवेटेड, सो सी बेरी. So as the word rhino represents the nose, so it represents the nose, means it is nasal polyp. Nasal polyp will be seen in rhinosporidiosis, and in this we used to see that this is a spherules, this is a spherules, and inside it spores will be there. As we can see here, lot of spores will be there. So outer boundary is spherules, and inside it spores will be present. So what is the cause of rhinosporidiosis? So rhinosporidiosis is Rhinosporidium seaberry. Rhinosporidium seaberry. The causes is Rhinosporidium seaberry, and which is now classified as it is not like it is as I am I. As I am teaching you this topic in the fungi, but now it is no more fungi. Now it is reclassified as a parasite. So now reclassified as parasite. It is reclassified as a parasite. Now what were the clinical features? As the name Rhinosporidium, rhino represents the nose. So in this nasal polyps will be seen. And rarely some genital or eye-like features will be seen. Genital and eye features will also be seen. What is the diagnosis? For diagnosis of Rhinosporidium, we use microscopic examination, because this cannot be get cultivated. So it cannot be cultivated. What is the treatment of Rhinosporidium? So whenever Rhinosporidium will occur, means nasal polyps will be occur, we have to do excision. So for the treatment, we have to do excision. So this is the topic which I covered in this video, that is the chromoblastomycosis, the Rhinosporidium, Pneumocystis jirovecii, and the first topic, that is the eumycetoma and actinomycetoma. I hope this video is very useful to you guys. Thank you, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.